Welcome back to Sunday Brunch Live. We are live, and I must apologise. There was a swear word in the cooking item in the last part, and apologies for that. We're now joined by Sir Cliff Richard. Welcome to the show.
Thank you
for coming here. And a huge congratulations are in order, because you're celebrating 60 years in the music industry.
I know, but when I was young, I never thought I'd be 60. You know, you always felt that you're never going to live that long. And now it's very difficult for me to believe that it's been 60 years. But if you don't think about it, if you ask the years go by, you don't really count.
Yeah.
Other people count, and then suddenly I'm hearing, oh my God, 60 years.
But you've kept going. You know, it's not as if you stopped and did a comeback. You've always been around. You've never stopped performing.
Well, that could be used as a criticism, of course. But I just feel that one of the reasons why I'm still here is that I actually like it. I mean, I like it. I still like to tour. I can't play stadiums and things anymore. The Stones still can. I don't know how they did it. But I still like performing. So as long as people want to come out and see a concert, I'm happy to do it. I don't want to retire. But I have tried to make life easier for myself. I don't work quite as hard, even though I still record, I still do concerts, I still do TV shows. And it's fun. It's all part of being having the fun aspect. Yeah. And I think that's what's helped me to continue, and therefore the public recognise that too.
Is that the secret of your longevity, do you think, then, having fun?
Well, I'm not a bad singer. Not everybody's favourite, I have to say, but...
good answer.
I've done all right with it. And funnily enough, I was asked recently, they said, what, if you were starting now, do you think, how far do you think you'd go? I said, well, if I was the same as I was since 1958, in terms of how I sang, I don't think I'd get past the first record. Because nowadays, the young folks that come through, they're so good. They've had 60 or more than that, how long is this rock and roll? About 70 years of influences that they don't even know exist. They've listened to all these records that have come to them, and they are so good now, much better than we were when we started. I think we had to learn our way. Right from scratch. I had no singing lessons, no dancing lessons, no acting lessons. You just picked it up as you went along.
So tell us
a lot of luck is involved.
Tell us about 58 then, because it was sort of the birth of popular music, was it?
Well, in England it was, 57, 58. I started in 58. I was 17 when I made my first record. So Justin Bieber? Well, he was 17 too.
Yeah.
So nothing's really changed in that aspect. He's again, when I think about me at 17, he dances, he sings, he writes. I mean, it's amazing how talented people are today. We had to really fight our way through, to be honest with you, and I don't understand how we ever made it. And for me, when I look back at those old clips of the Oh Boy show, which was in black and white, I would sing with Marty Wilde. He'd look really cool, and I'd look like a greasy slob. And I'm still here. I'll never understand it.
But I've never thought of that before. What you just said. I think it's really true that, you know, now people have the history going back to the 50s. So what were your reference point when you started? Because music suddenly changed.
It did, but the reference point was the rock and roll scene that came from America. You know, apparently Fats Domino is reputed to have made the first rock and roll record, which was called "I Am the Fat Man," and then. What I heard, though, was Elvis Presley's Heartbreak Hotel. Suddenly there was Bill Haley, there was Little Richard, Buddy Holly, the Everly Brothers. It was just fantastic. And so that's how we were influenced. And funnily enough, I heard Sting did an interview. I didn't hear it, I read it. And the journalist said to him, you know, you live in America, you work in America. And he said, well, what are you? And Sting said, I am British, but my soul is American. And you know, I've been trying to articulate how I feel about things, and that's basically it. We were given our lives, our souls were filled with this fantastic music that changed everything from the Sinatras and Crosbys, who, they were pretty good singers too, you know. But they didn't inspire our generation, whereas Elvis did. So had there been no Elvis, I don't think there could possibly have been a Cliff Richard, and probably not even the Beatles.
Wow.
Even though they started 5 years after me, they were the same age as us, the Shadows and I, and they, it turns out, listened to the same Elvis, Little Richard, Buddy Holly, the Everly Brothers, and so you just wonder if that hadn't happened, maybe we would have happened, but it wouldn't have been the same.